Hi, welcome to Erratic Solutions. In continuation with previous two instruction set, data transfer, arithmetic and logical. So now I'm talking about call and jump instruction set from 8051 controller. So the other name of this, conditional and unconditional jump instructions from assembly language. Okay, so this is your complete instruction set from assembly language about talks about call and CJNE. So these instructions you can use for all conditions. Whenever you are trying to write conditions in assembly language from 8051 controller, you need to use this instruction set. I'll explain one by one. So let's follow the syntaxes. From this, A call is a mnemonic and SADD is your short address, which is your label indirectly. It means why it is named as call and jump. The name itself, jump, means based on expression, based on condition, you have to change your execution from one location to another location from your program memory. So whenever you are trying to use call instruction, the call instruction usage is very clear. It helps to execute your subroutines, like a functions from C language. If someone is looking to execute some repeated lines from your application, so you can make it as group and you can fix one name for that. And whenever you are looking to execute those repeated lines, you can execute by using simply call instruction from assembly language. The same thing we are doing in C language. If you are looking to execute those lines, simply you will give function name and you will call that in the main program. So in assembly language, the call instruction you can use to execute those subroutines. So how microcontroller can jump from one location to another location? That's why it is comes under jump instructions. Means I am leaving one ROM memory location from program memory and I am jumping to some other location to execute some other thing. Followed by SADD, which means short address. In programs, so this address you are mentioning through labels. I'll give one name, one label name. Now the compiler search for this label where it is present in the program. Always call instruction followed by your label name. And there are two call instruction, A call and L call. So A call, which helps to execute with name itself absolute call, and L call is long call. So both are used to execute your subroutines, but depends on your program size, you need to take it different ways. If your subroutine is present in less than 2 kilobytes, you can prefer A call. Your subroutine is present more than 2 kilobytes, you can prefer L call. So this is the view of your call instruction from assembly language. So you can write different instructions from your program, but whenever compiler find this call instruction, which always mentioned through labels, on what compiler it is going to leave this ROM location here and it comes to execute this instruction 1, instruction 2, instruction 3. So these instructions which are repeatedly used in main program, so this subroutine you can use many times as you required in a main program. It is not one time execution, so you may call number of times. How many times you are going to use this call instruction, so that number of times your subroutine is going to execute. But how compiler returns from subroutine to main program, it will find the last statement from your subroutine, RET. So with the help of this RET, it will leave this subroutine and it returns to main program after call instruction. And it continues the instructions after call. So this is the use of call instruction from assembly language. So finally, your call instruction which helps to execute subroutines from the program. And what is the subroutine? It contains the repeated lines of your application program. Now the second instruction, which is CJNE, is a mnemonic. A ADD and RADD, these are operands. So CJNE instruction clear understanding. So CGME always follows two operands followed by label. So what is the use of the CGME and for which purpose I can use the CGME here? To compare two operands. Again, comparison means you can find the relation between two operands, whether two operands are equal or two operands are not equal, and one operand is less than second operand and first operand is greater than operand. So to know the relation between two operands, you can use the CGME instruction from assembly language. The instruction itself, it will check whether equal or not equal. But from instruction table, so it affects your carry flag. The CGME possibilities are A with address location, A with constant value, which means accumulator with constant value, general purpose register with constant value, pointer register with constant value. So you can know these four possibilities, means you have to follow these four syntaxes for CGME instruction. It doesn't support other syntaxes like address with address value, general purpose register and general purpose register value. You cannot compare. So if you are looking to compare two values, first keep it your value in A and second value in address as per this syntax, or else accumulator with constant value you can directly compare, general purpose register and constant value you can directly compare, pointer register and constant value you can directly compare. And RADD means relative address. Relative address means indirectly it is a label to which address you are going to jump, that you have to mention through label names. So your CGME instruction finally helps to know the relation between two operands. Equal, not equal, you can directly know through instruction. But if you are trying to know this less than, greater than relation, your carry flag you have to monitor. If operand 1 is less than operand 2, carry flag remains 0. Sorry, if operand 1 is less than operand 2, carry flag becomes 1. If operand 1 is greater than operand 2, carry flag remains 0. Means to know this less than greater than relation, you need to check carry flag. Equal, not equal, you can directly say through instruction. But if you are trying to know less than greater than relation, check your carry flag. So that's why. So you have to check your carry flags, affected flags for your CGME. And DJNZ, which means it deals with decrement jump not equal to 0. The operand value, you get only one operand for your DJNZ followed by label. So any instruction, anyway, you are trying to do any operation some limited number of times, you can use the DJNZ instruction. It will decrement the value by 1. If it is not equal to 0, again it goes to the label. Suppose the operand value becomes 0, then the execution goes to the next line of this DJNZ. So that's why this also comes under conditional jump. Your CJNE and DJNZ both are comes under conditional jump instructions. The possibilities with DJNZ is general purpose register with relative address, and you can use address with address location as a operand, and relative address means label. So this is the use of CJNE and DJNZ. I'll show you example with this CJNE and DJNZ instructions. Now there are three other simple jump instructions: A jump followed by short address, L jump followed by long address, S jump followed by relative address, which means labels. These three comes under unconditional jump instructions. There is no operand as a part of instruction, so that simply it will jump from one ROM location to another ROM location. Or else you can use these three instructions as infinite loops also. Without checking any condition, you can repeat your process infinite number of times. So this is the use of three jump instructions from assembly language. Now jump at the rate of A plus DPTR. Suppose if you are trying to jump one specific location of ROM memory, you can assign your ROM address to DPTR and you can use the standard syntax jump at the rate of A plus DPTR. Whatever the address you assign with DPTR, it directly jumps to that specific address. Now JC, JNC, so these two instructions use it for carry logic checking. Jump if carry logic is 1. If carry logic is 1, you can take certain action. Suppose you are trying to check carry logic with 0, then you can follow this JNC syntax. So JNC syntax, which will help to know what is carry status. If it is 0, then it will jump to label in the case of JNC. In the case of JC, based on carry logic, it will jump from one location to another location. Whereas JBB label, which means jump if bit, there are bit addressable locations from RAM memory from 8051, which are saved in 20H to 2FH, 16 locations of bit addressable space. If you want to know the status of individual bits from bit addressable space, you can follow this syntax JB followed by any bit addressable bit. One single bit logic you can test. If it is 1, you can follow the label. If it is 0, the execution goes to next line in the case of JBB label. Suppose you want to check bit addressable logic is 0, then you can use this JNBB label syntax, which is used to jump if no bit. No bit means logic 0. If bit addressable location logic 0, then you are looking to jump, you can use this syntax. And JZ, JNZ. So these two instructions to know the accumulator value is 0 or non-zero. So you want to test accumulator value is 0, then use this JZ syntax. JZ syntax doesn't have any operand, but instruction itself, it works on accumulator directly. JZ followed by label. And JNZ, which means accumulator value non-zero. So this is how your condition and jump instructions from assembly language. And the last two instructions, RET, one RET is used for subroutines to return from subroutine to main program. And the last one, RETI, which is for return from interrupt service routine to main program. So even you can write interrupt service routines for your applications. So whenever you are giving external interrupt or software interrupt, microcontroller stops main program and it jumps to ISR execution. And how compiler returns to main program? By finding this RETI instruction from assembly language. So this is how your call and jump instruction set works from assembly language. I'll show you some examples with DJNZ and CJNE. To write programs in assembly language, you can use Keil Microvision IDE. This is one popular IDE for microcontrollers. You can develop any assembly language programs or embedded C programs by using this Keil Microvision. So let's follow the steps one by one to write program, to compile program, to debug the program using Keil Microvision IDE. So just install your Keil Microvision IDE, click on project tab and choose the option new Microvision project. Now I'm giving my project name as call jump. This is your device selection window. Now you have to choose your specific microcontroller. KL Microvision supports for all different manufacturers here. You can develop programs for any microcontroller from this list. Not only admin, you can write programs for top companies in embedded technology, which are Samsung, Philips, Cypress Semiconductors, Honeywell. So don't think that your KL Microvision is applicable for only Atmel. No, you can develop programs for all other microcontrollers also. From this list, I'm working with specific manufacturer, which is Atmel. Now choose your manufacturer and click on plus mark. You'll get list of devices from this manufacturer. From this list, you need to choose one microcontroller, which is AT89C51. Select your device and click on OK. Now this is your startup code warning. If you want to add the startup code with your project, click on S, otherwise no. Up to now, you created a project and you are working with specific target device, which is Atmel AT89C51. To write a program, go File tab and click on New. This is your text editor. Here you can type your programs. Now I'm writing example for DJ NZ. So I'm taking count R0 value as 10. So this is a program for complement accumulator value 10 times. So I'm taking some random value on accumulator. Now just see the usage of DJ NZ. So DJ NZ R0 comma back. So this back label I am applying for complement operation. So that what kind of output you are expecting? The accumulator value I am assigning with 45 and R0 as 10 count. And I am writing instruction for complement accumulator value CPLA DJNZ, which means decrement your operand value R0 by 1 so that it becomes 9. If it is not equal to 0, follow this label, means back. Again, your accumulator value is going to complement. Like this, this complement operation will happen up to count 0. So for every time your accumulator is complemented, and operand value decrements by 1. So I'll write title of the program. Complement accumulator value 10 times. So now after writing program in text editor, you have to save this program. Again, go with the option file and use save. And now I'm saying call and jump dot asm. So remember, you have to save your program with dot asm extension because you are writing programs in assembly language. So you should save with dot asm extension. Click on save. And whatever the program you are trying to compile, you need to add with target. Just select your target one window and click on plus mark. You will get source group one. Which source file you are trying to compile? Right click it and choose the option add files to source group one. So it will show you default C source files, but your source file is now assembly language. So you need to change to ASM. And I'm selecting my specific file colon jump dot asm. Select and add and close it. You can cross check whether file is added or not here. After doing this, again go with project tab and choose option build a target. It will show you errors and warnings present in the program. So if you have zero errors and zero warnings, you can enter into debug session to check the output of this program. If you do any mistakes, as not giving space between numeric and operands, or not placing comma between operands. So if you do any mistake, every time if you do any modification, save and build. These two are shortcut buttons. You can directly use these buttons. Now I am entering into debug session to check the output of this program. Select debug tab and choose option start and stop debug session. So this is evolution mode warning for trial versions. If you have licensed, it doesn't show you this warning. Now click on OK. There is no issue with this. Now, so you to execute this program line by line, use function key F11. So now your first line is executed. The value 45 H's comes with accumulator. And R0 value, which will show you A, because even you are assigning decimal values, it will show you hexadecimal format. And if you are complementing your 45H, you will get BA. So 4 complement is B and 5 complement is A. So I got BAH. But now check your R0 value. It is decremented by 1. So it becomes 9. And again complement. If BA is complemented, you will get 45. So again 08 count and BA like this. So I am showing just simple example on DJ NJ working. So like this. So this compilation will runs until count value becomes 0. So whenever count value becomes 0, then the compilation stops. There is no line to execute. So this is how you can use your DJ NZ for any action you are trying to do. Some limited number of times you can use DJ NZ instruction from assembly language. This is one important instruction, and also CJNE. CJNE also you can use for compare two operand values. I'll write one example on CJNE. So if you want to work with same project, you can remove only program and you can open new text editor just by clicking on file tab and text. So I am trying to move two values with register A, and second operand I am taking as address, some 10H RAM location. So this is for finding smallest number from two numbers. So I want to know whether A value is small or 10H value is small. So to know the relation between two operands, so you can use this syntax CJNE A comma 10H. So I am using label name check. So as per syntax, so CJNE helps to know only equal not equal. But if you are looking for smallest number, what you need to check? So you need to check carry logic. To check carry logic, which instruction you can use? JC. So if carry is coming, A is small, the label name small. So I'll get this smallest number into some 20H address. So if carry is coming, second operand is bigger than first operand. So A is the smallest one. Suppose carry is not coming, then second operand is smaller than first operand. But the execution follows the sequence lines. So I am just breaking this sequence execution by using simple sjmp instruction. So as a result, I need to execute either MOV 20H, A or MOV 20H, 10H. So I am not looking to execute both lines. If carry is coming, then A is smaller than 10H. If carry is not coming, 10H is smaller than A. So if carry is not coming, then simply execute this line and skip this MOV 20H, A execution. How to skip? By using simple sjmp instruction. So now I am trying to save this program as small.asm. If you want to check this output, just again add your file with source group, change it to asm source file, select your program which is small.asm, add and close. Now build it. So whatever the program you added with source group, that program is going to debug. Select debug tab and start debug session. Click on OK. Now, so where I am expecting my smallest number? Into 20H. So to check RAM memory locations, use letter D. D stands for data memory followed by address. So now by default in 20H location there is no answer, but once you execute this program line by line, you will get smallest number into 20H. If you want to execute this program line by line, use function key F11. The first value I got into A and second value I got into 10H. If you want to know, check your 10H location here. The 10H location received 32. Now I am comparing CJNE A, 10H. To know this carry logic, you can expand your PSW register. Now your carry doesn't disturb, so carry remains 0. So if carry is not coming, which one is small? Second operand is small. So this condition goes fail, the execution goes to next line. So what is the next line? MOV 20H, 10H. So I need to check this 20H address. Initially it is 0. If you execute this line, you will get 32. Yeah, let's check. And now I am trying to skip this MOV 20H, A. Otherwise, if you are not writing this, your MOV 20H, A also executes. So I am skipping this line by using simple sjmp instruction. So this is how you can use your CJNE for finding relation between two numbers, and also you can cross check your carry flag by using JC or JNC. So you can write many programs with this condition and jump instructions with assembly language. So for further videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, Aerotech Solutions, and give your valuable feedback through comment, and like and share. And we are from Aerotech Solutions. We are giving 3 levels training for all working and BTech and graduates and electronics persons, diploma students, and we are doing services on different categories: online, classroom, internships, and you will do even projects, and you will go with level wise. The first level you are talking about C, data structures and Linux and microcontrollers, assembly language, embedded C, and you are working on protocols UART, I2C, SPI, CAN. The second level you will talk about Python programming with 32-bit architecture boards, IPC2148, Raspberry Pi, STM32 and many more 32 boards. You can do IoT applications with those advanced feature controllers. The third level, you will talk about operating system concepts with device drivers. Here system programming, network programming, and kernel image build. So you'll have better training procedure here. And if you have any, we are looking for any online training, please call back with this number 9676327118. If you have any doubts, please WhatsApp us. Even you are offering individual levels and job guarantee program with these three levels completion. If you want to reach our office, please follow this address, Rajamma Towers, flat number 103, Jayanagar, Bhagyanagar Colony, Kukatpally, near KPHP Metro Station, Hyderabad, Telangana, India. And if you have any queries, please write an email ysnanda@eratechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.